हेलो एवरीवन, आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू द महिला समाचार डिजिटल क्लासेस। दिस इज योर मैथ्स ट्यूटर फ्रॉम महिला समाचार हाई स्कूल। टुडे इन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द कॉन्सेप्ट पॉलीगंस। चिल्ड्रन, today's concept is polygons. Poly means many, gon means or gonia means angles. The many angled geometrical figures, many angled geometrical figures are called as polygons. Let us know about the polygons in detail. Children, now let us explore about the definition of polygons. Children, polygon is a closed plane figure. Polygon is a closed plane figure which is formed by three or more sides. That sides are considered as line segments. There are two conditions for the polygons. One is the segments only intersect at end points. And no adjacent sides are collinear. That means no any two sides should lie on the same line, or the angle between the adjacent sides should not be the 180 degree. So that a polygon is a closed plane figure formed by three or more sides that are line segments. The segments only intersect at end points and no adjacent sides are collinear. Children, polygons are named using the letters of consecutive vertices. Children, in this case, see, this one is the polygon because it is a closed figure and also it is a plane figure. Closed means all the sides are intersect at their end points, and plane figure means it is only the two-dimensional figure formed by three or more sides. See here, this figure is formed by the five sides: side AB, side BC, side CD, side DE, and side EA are the five sides of the polygon. So that a polygon is a closed plane figure formed by three or more sides that are line segments. Children, here we can name this polygon as ABCDEA. ABCDEA. It is five-sided polygon, so we can call it as pentagon. And see, children, in this second figure, we can observe this. Here also, there are four sides and five vertices, but it is not considered as a polygon because it is not a closed figure. Here A and E vertices are not joined. It is not a closed figure. Then in this case, see, A, B, C, D, E, it is also not considered as a polygon because it is also intersected between the end points. See, the two sides intersect between the end points, so that it is also not considered as a polygon. Children, later we'll study about this type of polygons. These type of polygons are called as complex polygons. If they intersect at between the end points, then it is considered as complex polygon. We'll study about this later. So that, say, this one is the polygon, this is not the polygon, and this one is also not the polygon. Now let us move on to the next concept. Children, in this, one more condition is there to conclude the polygon. See, this one is the polygon because it is a closed plane figure bounded by four sides. Here, the semicircle is not considered as a polygon. Why? Because means it has a curved surface. If any geometrical figure has a curved surface, means then it is not considered as polygon. See, this one is considered as polygon because it has no curved surface and all the sides are closed. Then children, this is not a plane figure or it is not a polygon. Why it is not a polygon means here also there is a curved surface or curved line, curved face, so that it is also not considered as a polygon. Children, polygon is a combination of two words. Poly means many, gon means corners. So the polygon is arises from two Greek words meaning many means the poly and gon means corners. We can also say the corners as angles, so that many angled figures are called as polygons. It should not have any curved surface, and it should not there is no intersection of sides of the polygon, and no adjacent sides are collinear. Collinear means they should not lie on the same line, or the angle between them at the point of intersection should not be 180 degree. Children, here in this figure you can identify the side, vertex, diagonal, interior angle and exterior angle of the polygon. Children, see here, this point, the point where any two sides of the polygon intersect is called as vertex. See, this is one vertex and this is another vertex. This is one of the vertex. This is one of the vertex. This one is another vertex. Then this is one of the vertex. Totally how many vertices are there means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, totally 6 vertices are there. Then see, the line segment which joins any two vertices is called as side of the polygon. So this is the side of the polygon, and the line segment which joins any two opposite vertices of the polygon is considered as diagonal of the polygon. So the angle inside the polygon is considered as interior angle, then the angle outside the polygon is considered as exterior angle. Exterior angle means the angle outside the polygon. Interior angle means the angle inside the polygon. Diagonal means the line segment which joins any two opposite vertices of the polygon. Side of a polygon means the line segment which joins any two adjacent vertices of the polygon. Vertex means the point where any two sides of the polygon intersect. I hope you understood, children. Now let us move on to the next concept. Now let us study about the types of polygons. Children, polygons are classified into various types based on the sides and measures of the angles. They are regular polygon and irregular polygon, concave polygon and convex polygon, then simple polygon and complex polygon are the major types of polygons. Regular polygon and irregular polygon, concave polygon and convex polygon, simple polygon and complex polygon are the major three types of polygons. Let us explore about these types of polygons one by one. Children, first let us know about the first type of polygons, that is regular and irregular polygons. Regular polygons and irregular polygons. Children, let us explore about the regular polygon. In a regular polygon, all the sides of the polygon are equal and all the interior angles are the same. That means in any polygon, if all the sides are equal and all the interior angles are also same, that means they are equal to one another, means then the polygon is considered as regular polygon. For example, a regular hexagon. Regular hexagon. Hexagon means a six-sided polygon has six equal sides and all its interior angles measures to 120 degrees. So few more examples are mentioned here. See, it is a square. In a square, all the four sides are equal to one another and all the four angles are equal to 90 degrees. Then it is an example for equilateral triangle. In an equilateral triangle, all the three sides are equal to one another and each angle of the equilateral triangle measures 60 degrees. And if we take the example of a regular pentagon, it has five equal sides and all the interior angle measures 108 degrees. Children, see, I think you understood about the regular polygons. Regular polygon means all the sides and all the angles of the polygon must be equal to one another. In a regular polygon, all the sides of polygon are equal and all the angles are interior angles are the same. Here, the regular hexagon, square, equilateral triangle, then regular pentagon, regular octagon, etc. are the examples for regular polygon. Children, now let us know about the irregular polygon. Children, a polygon with an irregular shape. Irregular shape, it means the sides and angles of the polygon are not equal means. Then it is called as irregular polygon. For example, a quadrilateral, especially a trapezium with unequal sides. A trapezium has unequal sides. So a trapezium is an example for irregular polygon. And an isosceles triangle. You know about the isosceles triangle. Two sides of the triangle are equal to one another. An isosceles triangle has only two of its sides are equal and the third side has a different measurement, so that an isosceles triangle is considered as irregular polygon. Then a scalene triangle is also an example for irregular polygon. Children, irregular polygon means a polygon with an irregular shape, or it means the sides and angles of the polygon are not equal. The example for irregular polygons are trapezium, isosceles triangle, scalene triangle, etc. Children, observe the regular polygons and irregular polygons. In case of triangles, so this one is the regular triangle and this one is the irregular triangle. So this is the regular quadrilateral and this one is the irregular quadrilateral. Regular pentagon, irregular pentagon. By observing the figures itself, you can say which one is the regular and which one is the irregular. Then regular hexagon, irregular hexagon. Regular octagon, irregular octagon. Regular means all the sides and all the angles are equal to one another. Irregular means the sides are different. The measure of the side, each side of the polygon are different and angles are also different. So such polygons are called as irregular polygons. Children, observe the regular polygons and irregular polygons clearly and understand the concept of regular and irregular polygons. I hope you understood about the regular and irregular polygons. Now, let us move on to the next concept. Children, the next concept is concave and convex polygons. Children, to understand the concave and convex polygons, let us go through with the convex pentagon and concave pentagon. Convex pentagon means, children, if any polygon, if all the interior angles are less than 180 degree. In case of pentagon, we can observe here, each angle of the pentagon is less than 180 degree. So if all the interior angles of a pentagon is less than 180 degree, then it is considered as convex pentagon. Concave pentagon means at least any one of the interior angle is greater than 180 degree. Here you can observe, children, here in this figure, see here, any one of the angle, that means this angle is greater than 180 degree. So this is considered as concave pentagon. Concave pentagon means at least one interior angle is greater than 180 degree. Convex pentagon means all the interior angles are less than 180 degree. Concave pentagon means at least one interior angle is greater than 180 degree. So now let us know about the convex polygon and concave polygon. Convex polygon means the same definition applies to the convex polygon also. In a polygon, if all the interior angles are less than 180 degree, then it is called as convex polygon. Then concave polygon means, in a polygon, if at least one interior angle is greater than 180 degree means, then it is considered as concave polygon. Children, let us know about convex and concave polygon in detail. Children, here is the definition for concave polygon. Children, in a concave polygon, at least one angle measures more than 180 degrees. The vertices of concave polygon are inwards as well as outwards. See, the point B is, see this point is inward, this point. Point B is inward. The vertex, vertex B is inwards, and the other vertices, vertex A, vertex F, vertex E, vertex D and vertex C are the outward vertices. So that, see, a concave polygon means at least one angle measures more than 180 degree, and in case of concave polygons, the vertices of a concave polygon are inwards as well as outwards. Now, let us know about the convex polygon. In a convex polygon, all measure of the interior angles is less than 180 degree. Children, as I said, in case of convex pentagon, see, each interior angle must be measures less than 180 degree. So, if all the interior angles of a polygon measures less than 180 degree, then it is considered as convex polygon. It is exactly opposite to concave polygon. In case of concave polygon, any one of the angle is greater than 180 degree. The vertices of convex polygon are always outwards. And see, in this example, there is an irregular hexagon whose vertices are outwards. Vertices are A, B, C, D, E, F, and these are outwards. All the five vertices are outwards. Dear children, now let us know about the simple and complex polygons. These are the third types of polygons, simple and complex polygons. Children, Children, in this figures and in this diagrams, you can identify the simple polygon and complex polygon. Children, simple polygon means which have no self-intersecting sides. That means the sides of the polygon never cross over each other. But the complex polygon is also called as self-intersecting polygons. Self-intersecting polygon. See, in self-intersecting polygon, the sides cross over each other. The sides of the polygon cross over each other. Children, by observing the figures itself, you can understand the concept of simple polygon and complex polygon. In simple polygon, there is no self-intersecting sides. But in case of complex polygon, there is self-intersecting sides and sides cross over each other. Children, now let us introduce about the polygon people and friends. That means names of the polygons depending upon their sides. So polygon people and friends will be introduced for you now. Children, names of the polygons depends on the number of sides. So the Greek words are used to denote the names of the polygons. Let us know about these names of the polygons one by one depending upon the sides of the polygons. Dear children, let us know about the pentagon. Children, pentagon is the combination of two Greek words. One is the penta, another one is gon. Children, penta is the Greek word which means five. Gon or gonia is the Greek word for angle. The five angled figure or five angled polygon is called as pentagon. In the same way, the each name of the polygon is composed of two Greek words. The first word of the polygon gives the number of sides, and second word is common, that is gon, so that means the angles. Penta means five, gon means angles. Children, based on the number of sides or number of angles, the polygons are named like this: triangle, three angled polygon. Tri means three, angle means angles. Three angled polygon is triangle. Next, quadrilateral or tetragon. Tetra means four, gon means angles. Four angled polygon is called as tetragon or quadrilateral. Pentagon, five angled polygon. Hexagon, six angled polygon. Heptagon, seven angled polygon. Octagon, eight angled polygon. Nonagon, nine angled polygon. Decagon, 10 angled polygon. So in the same way, let us know about the number of sides and names of the angles and each interior angle in a regular polygon. Children, here you can observe the name of the polygon and number of sides as well as number of vertices, then the measure of each interior angle. Children, in case of triangle, the number of sides are 3. Number of sides are 3, number of vertices are 3, and the each interior angle in case of a regular triangle measures 60 degree. Children, the next one is quadrilateral. It is also called as tetragon. Tetra means 4, gonia means angles. So four angled polygon is called as tetragon or quadrilateral. Here the number of sides are 4, number of vertices are 4, then each angle measures the 90 degree. Then pentagon means 5 angled polygon, number of sides are 5, number of vertices are 5, then each interior angle measures 108 degree in case of regular pentagon. Hexagon means 6 angled polygon. Hexa means 6, gonia means angles. So 6 vertices are there, 6 angles are there, 6 sides are there, then each interior angle measures 120 degree in case of regular hexagon. Children, in case of heptagon, the number of hepta means 7, gonia means angles. So 7 angled polygon is called as heptagon. So there are 7 sides, 7 vertices, 7 angles. Then each interior angle in case of regular heptagon measures 128.571 degree. Then octagon, octa means 8, gonia means angle. So 8 angled polygon is called as octagon. So number of sides are 8, number of vertices are 8, number of angles are 8. Then each interior angle measures 135 degree. Then nanagon or enneagon. Nanagon means, so the word nano indicates that 9 and gonia means angle. So 9 angled polygon is called as nanagon. So number of sides are 9, number of vertices are 9, number of angles are 9. Then each interior angle of regular nanagon measures 140 degree. Decagon means 10. Deca means 10, gonia means angles. So 10 angled polygon is called as decagon. So the number of sides are 10, number of angles are 10, number of vertices are 10. The each interior angle of a regular decagon measures 144 degree. Then hendecagon. Hendecagon means, hendeca means 11, gonia means sides, angles. So hendecagon means 11 angled polygon. So here number of sides are 11, number of angles are 11, and number of vertices are 11. Each interior angle measures 147.27 degree. Similarly, dodecagon. Dodecagon means, dodeca means 12, gonia means angles. 12 angled polygon is called as dodecagon. Number of sides are 12, number of angles are 12, number of angles are 12. Each interior angle of regular dodecagon measures 150 degree. Then tridecagon or triskaidecagon or means, trideca means 13, gonia means angles. So 13 angled polygon is called as tridecagon. Number of sides are 13, number of angles are 13, number of vertices are 13. Then each interior angle measures 152.3 degree. Next, tetradecagon or tetrakaidecagon. Tetradeca means 14, gonia means angles. So 14 angled polygon is called as tetradecagon. Children, the number of sides in tetradecagon are 14, number of vertices are 14, number of angles are 14. Then each interior angle measures 154.28 degree. Then pendecagon means, children, pendeca means 15, gonia means angle. So 15 angled polygon is called as pendecagon. So number of sides are 15, number of angles are 15. Each interior angle of regular pendecagon measures 156 degree. Then hexdecagon means 16, gonia means angles. 16 angled polygon is called as hexdecagon. Number of sides are 16, number of vertices are 16, number of angles are 16. So 157.5 degree is the each in measure of each interior angle of the hexadecagon. Children, heptadecagon. Heptadeca means 17. Gania means angles. 17 angled polygon is called as heptadecagon. 17 sides are there, 17 vertices are there, 17 angles are there. Then the each interior angle measures 158.82 degree. Then octadecagon means, octadeca means 18, gania means angles. So 18 angled polygon is called as octadecagon. So each side measures, that means 18 sides are there, 18 angles are there, 18 vertices are there. Each interior angle of octadecagon measures 160 degree. Then enneadecagon means 19 sided polygon, that means are 19 angled polygon, 19 angled polygon. Enneadeca means 19, gon means angles. So 19 angled polygon is called as enneadecagon. Number of sides are 19, number of angles are 19, number of vertices are 19. Then each interior angle of enneadecagon measures 161.05 degree in case of regular enneadecagon. Then icosagon, which is the important polygon. In case of icosagon, icosa means 20. In Greek language, icosa means 20. Gania means angles. So 20 angled polygon is called as icosagon. Here number of sides are 20, number of angles are 20, number of vertices are 20. Each interior angle measures 162 degree. Then so on, that means similarly, depending upon the number of sides, we can name the polygon by using the two Greek words. If the number of sides of a polygon are n, then it is called as n-gon. In case of n-gon, number of sides are n, number of vertices are n, number of angles are also n. Means how to calculate the each interior angle of regular n-gon means n minus 2 into 180 degree by n is the formula used to calculate the interior angle of n-gon, regular n-gon. Children, so I hope you understood about the names of the different types of polygons. Children, I hope you understood about the concept of polygons. Children, there are different types of polygons and there is different names for the polygons depending upon their number of angles or number of sides. I hope you understood the lesson polygons, and that means the concept of polygons. Thank you, children. Have a wonderful week.